For most high school students, beginning a new school year typically means new schedules, new teachers, and new classes. For LCM students, the start of the school year meant adapting to all of these things, plus adjusting to a campus that has turned into a construction zone over the past couple of months. While the construction has been a big adjustment for students and faculty, it is something that must happen in order to reap the benefits of a brand new school. LCM Principal Dr. Terry Estes is confident that the student body will successfully adapt to all of the changes on campus.
Hi, I'm with Dr. Estes. My name is Colby Perkins, and we're going to speak about the construction. Okay, so Dr. Estes, how do you think the construction of the school affects the students?
It affects us in quite a number of different ways. Most of us have been walking a lot more than we've ever walked in our lives, so we're getting fit in that sense. But I've been happily surprised that classes have seemed to be going fine. We haven't had any super disruption of the instruction process. Mm-hmm. And you know, we're still working through the bells, getting the bells back up and getting people to class on time. So there's some struggles that we're having. We had to make sure that everybody had enough water, so we've been working on that. But overall, I think we're having school, and that's our goal.
How has it affected you?
How's it affected me? You know, it affects your day-to-day routine quite a bit, because even in my office, the assistant principals have moved out to the hallways to be closer to y'all, and the people that are in the front office have changed around a little bit. So it's changed my daily routine. And what I've found is I'm out and about more. You know, when we were all in one spot and we had something to discuss, they just came into my office or I went into theirs. And now we're, you know, I'm walking down to the hall to speak to them, or we're out with directing traffic a little bit more than ever. So it's changed my daily routine quite a bit.
So you're seeing more of the school and getting more
involved? Yeah, it's been kind of fun. I'm seeing kids more than I did before.
On a positive note, what do you like about, like, the construction of the new school? What do you like about it?
I just think we have to keep our eyes on the prize and understand that it's going to be fabulous. When you look out in the quad and you see all that mud right now, if you think in a few short months that's going to be classrooms and we're going to have wide halls and one building, you know, it's worth it to me to put up with a little bit of discomfort now for how great it's going to be in the future.
Okay. What are the challenges of construction?
The biggest challenge is in any construction, you don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
You know, so you do the best you can and you plan and you work, but in any situation like this, there's going to be things that pop up and you just have to deal with them right then. So there's been a lot of people planning and working hard, but you know, I know that there are going to be things that happen, and we'll just have to make the best of it at that moment in time.
Okay. How do you think this affects the extracurricular activities?
I'm working really hard so that it won't.
Yeah.
You know, I just don't want it to. We had a really good school spirit going, and you know, we did band in the quad, and so I spent my morning talking to the band director and the cheerleader and drill team, and trying to make sure that when we do pep rallies, you know, there's something fun going on. Yeah. I'm working really hard so that it won't do that.
Okay. What improvements are being added to the school? Like, what's new?
What's coming?
Yeah, what's coming?
What's coming is going to be great. Just right out on the other side of the auditorium, they're going to build a new competition gym.
Ooh.
So that'll be great, and it'll be good for a lot of reasons. I know if you've been to an event in our gym, the sound system's not very good, and you can't really tell what people are saying. So we've tried to get it fixed, but it's just the way the building is built. It just doesn't have very good acoustics. So the new gym will not only be there for athletic events, when we have all our students in there, the sound system will be so that we can actually have events in it. They're going to build a new office complex on 87, where that sidewalk, you know, the driveway is poured out on Port 87.
Yeah.
So people will know where the front of the building is. That's really confusing if you've never been to LCM. And they'll have a new library and big classrooms and new hallways. It's basically going to be a new school on old bones.
Okay. How has the construction of the new school improved safety?
It will be incredibly beneficial just to have all of the classrooms inside. We'll have monitored entrances, so where the people come in now, you'll walk into a glass waiting area and we'll have to show your credentials and be buzzed in to get in, and the student access will be limited. You know, there won't be as many ways to get on campus, because right now it's just literally open. If you want to walk in, you walk in. So from a safety standpoint, it's going to be fabulous, and that was one of the goals when they designed the new building, was to make it safe for kids.
Who do you think is more infected? Who do you think is more affected, the upperclassmen or the underclassmen, and why?
I worried a little bit more about the upperclassmen because we're having to relearn. You know, when you've been in a building for 4 years and you are comfortable with it, and you know, you get to the end of the hall and you think, I just want to be right there, and you can't get there the way you're used to going. That's a little more frustrating. If you're a freshman and you've never been on campus, it's all you know. It's not quite as hard to learn it. So those of us that have been on campus a while are having to unlearn and then learn something new.
Like muscle memory.
You got to change that.
How do you feel about construction going on during school?
Well, we're working really hard to keep it safe. Mm-hmm. And so far the students have been very receptive to you know, doing what we've asked them to do. And the safety's always our first concern, making sure that kids, you know, the construction zones are fenced off and we don't have students in harm's way. So far I've not seen any big problems with it, and we're just going to work to keep it as safe as possible.
Okay, so there are many improvements to the school. What are your favorites and why?
What are my favorites? Mm-hmm. Inside hallways will be wonderful. Even before the construction, we were out in the weather all the time. You know, you were in your classroom, you went through the quad, so you were warm and cold and warm and cold, yeah. And wet and dry. And so to have a school where it's all inside and you get in the building and you're safe and warm, that will be wonderful. I'm looking forward to that. And they're building a brand new library over where the administration offices are now. And I'm a big library nut. Mm-hmm. So I'm anxious to see that. And it'll also have outside access, so we can open it up in the evenings for parents or students if there's events. And I think that would be a real asset to our community.
Yeah. How difficult will you think, what do you think will it be for the staff, like the people that worked here for a while?
Well, you know, they've just really had a positive attitude. Mm-hmm. We met right before school and tried to talk about how do we make it easier. And the teachers were the ones that came up with the idea of color coding the hallways and putting the signs up and the QR codes. So they've been really contributing to make it better. Mm-hmm. So far, I've just been thrilled with their response and their willingness to jump in and help us.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate the time.
It's my pleasure. Yeah. Anytime.
Okay. Done, I guess.